All right, so we're at Joe's house.
Got a doggy.
Marf.
There's the doggy.
We got a problem with outlets. GFI is not working. And we're going to do a quick test. So this is a tester just to find out if it's working. Okay, we got nothing. All right, so now we need to find what GFI supplies this. Now, do you have a GFI breaker or you're not sure?
Let's go to the basement.
Okay, off to the basement. GFI. Hall, living room, master bath, fridge, bedroom. All right, so we have an outlet here. We'll have to test this. Is that here when you bought the house? Or did they have to add this?
No, it was here.
So yeah. Single outlet.
That's probably upstairs.
Heat pump. Okay. So no. Just a regular outlet, okay.
Oh, is that one regular or is that a GFI?
This is regular. It'll be supplied by GFI. Get the hots there. Alright, so this is another outlet. We'll take this one apart. So when did this stop working? We got power here, but this is the end, so there's nothing feeding this except something else.
Yeah.
All right, so this outlet's working. We need to identify what GFI supplies this. So we got power. Yep, we just tripped it. But that's the breaker, or not. All right, good. You go ahead, you can start tripping breakers.
Alright, here it is. I'll try. This is GFI, GFI, I can try that one.
Yeah, try it. Nope. Usually bath is usually dedicated to the bathroom by code. Alright, so it's not that.
Alright, Wi-Fi was not that. I'll try it flying.
Nope. No. Is that all the single pole breakers? Oh, wait, it's off. It's off.
How about now?
It's back on.
All right, this one here.
What breaker number is that?
It says weatherproof.
Oh, okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does. Okay, so go ahead and turn that one off. All right, so we identified what the breaker is. Joe just kept switching breakers. Now that breaker's off, I can take apart this outlet and verify that the connections to the GFI output are secure enough, because I have a feeling that one outlet in the front is supplied by this GFI and there could be a problem with the connection inside. All right, so now I'm going to take apart the outlet. First thing I'm removing is the cover. The reason why I'm removing this outlet is because I want to inspect the wired connections. And I'm guessing that there's only two wires that are coming into this, but who knows? This is the problem right there. Quick connects. So once we fix this, you're going to have a working GFI. So these two wires need to be connected. So here is the GFI line, that's the supply, and load. The wires aren't even connected. So when I pulled the outlet out, The one wire was disconnected and the other one just popped right off of the bag. So these are not quick connects. These are secured with this screw. Hey Joe, I think this will work.
Oh, here's some wire.
Yeah. So we'll see if we can get this tight. Okay, that's tight. That's not going anywhere. All right, so let me get this connected. You know what? Go trip the breaker. Turn it back on. And then, no, because I'll see the red light, and then we'll test the other outlets. All right, outlet is back on. Test it. Okay, so we're running here. Oop. Okay, now we're gonna go test the other outlets. Here we go. Got power, bro.
Alright.
So that's what it was. Yo! Oh, yeah. I fixed your shit.
Oh, you did? What was wrong with it?
You understand GFI and all that?
Yeah.
Alright, so there's a feeder for the GFI and then there's outputs.
Uh-huh.
Well, they had two outputs. Oh. One went to something that was working and the other one went to this.
Oh, to this?
So the two wires, so the one went to the back and that was working, right, Joe?
Yeah.
So anyway, the wires were loose on the outlet. So every time you plug in something and unplug it, you know, it loosens the screw just a little bit more.
Yeah.
Well, eventually it just worked its way out.
I just called it.
So now
but
I'm making
was,
a...
It was doing the same thing though before.
Yeah. If you click the fridge up, it'll trip it. So there's a
piece. Yeah, I'll run you.
Right?
No, I can do it. I'll just run you another outlet.
The problem is I don't do it. We don't have the cable, so I got a piece of cable.
No, I'll tell you everything you need to buy, and you get it, I'll hook you up. Yeah, but I'm making a video of this for my channel.
Is that why you have GoPro?
Yeah.
I love the one. If you're into home...
Oh, yeah. If you...
I'm going to put this pad down. If you're into DIY home repairs...
You know, I tried doing a solid... like minute and a half of me talking, I couldn't. I kept up.
Right.
So I'm like,
I took 30 some cakes,
and I'm like, just going to edit the shit out of this. So I took little parts of each one. I'm like, you know, this is kind of funny.
It was funny. Did you see that on Facebook?
We're in my home office. This is my home office. If you like room makeovers, can you reset the GFI? No, in the garage. Just hit the reset button.
So Joe, he posted his outtakes.
Yeah, I'll show you. I'll send it to you. I'll post it on Facebook.
The one with the truck.
Yeah. Okay, that's working.
The truck.
I think it's got like 40,000. Oh, the one in the trains. That was amazing what they did with the conduit. They were able to run wires through the conduit.
So this outlet's working. We're just putting it all back together. The source of the problem was loose wires in the GFI. So Joe's putting this outlet back in for me. Now you gotta finish, you're not done.
I'll see how much I need to go here.
Yeah, it'll go all the way. There's a little bit more. I'll hand tighten it, don't go any further.
Can't pull it towards your butt.
What?
There's an outtake for you for next year.
Outtake what?
For you next year.
I think it needs to be reset. Oh, it's tripping.
It's tripping already?
Yeah, there's something wrong. It won't reset.
I think this is what it did before too.
So the GFI will not reset. And it could be a couple things. It could be something I did wrong someplace else. When I installed the outlets, or in here, there could be a wire touching, like ground wire could be touching the output. That's what a GFI ground fault protector gets, is a ground fault. So when the hot wire contacts ground, it will trip. See that wire is popping out. That neutral. You just call my cell phone. Just call my cell phone when you get down there. All right, good. Turn it on.
All right, come on. Ready?
Yep.
On.
All right, let me reset it. Nope, it's not going on. All right, turn it off. And stay down there. I gotta disconnect something, hold on. All right, turn it back on. Joe, I got no freaking clue what's going wrong. All right, you can hold on a minute. Let me try something else. Oh, that was weird. You know what? I think we got a problem in that last outlet. I put it together. So turn it off and come back up. There you go. Turn it on. Yep. Okay, I think that fixed it. So, let's see. What do I have here? Stay down there, turn it off. Okay, turn it back on. Oh, I just saw a spark. Okay. All right, turn it back off. And stay there. Turn it back on. Okay, turn it off. Okay, so I use the driver to get it in close to the wall, but then I tighten up by hand so I don't over tighten it and strip the screw or whatever. Plug this in. trip it, reset it. Now we're gonna go to the other outlets and make sure that they're working. So stay here. When you hear it trip, give it a 5 second count, then reset it. Because I want to see that the light goes out and comes back on. Plug in the tester. And I'm working with Joe. Light's on. Okay, now I'm going to wait for it to come back on. Okay. That's working. Now we'll go out back, do the same thing. So now I plug in this guy, it's working. I trip it, wait for him to turn it back on, and there we go. Teamwork. All right, it's good, man. So now, what's that?
Plug this stuff back in.
Yep, plug it in. So let's go talk about your, where would you want the outlet at?
Yeah,
so is the basement's below there, right?
This mess up.
What's that?
See this mess over here? All this hooking.
What?
That's for the
what? System. Okay, so you need an outlet here too.
Well, just
is the basement? Is there a basement below this?
Yeah.
Okay, that's easy.
Well, that's the subfloor, the cement floor, but that's the wall because this stuff.
Yeah.
Put one over here for the fridge. That's all we gotta do.
Well, we could put one there and one there.
Yeah, or that.
I mean, because if you're gonna do it, you might as well do it. You're gonna be there, right?
Yeah.
And I'd put it 20 amp in.
Oh yeah, there you go. See up there. Just come through here.
Yeah. Yeah. So we just have to pick the spot to the left and the right of the stairs. Because if you're gonna drill a hole, you might as well drill two holes. And we can't do it here because you don't have any room in the panel, but we can do it over here. So we'll come over here. All right, so this panel, Siemens panel, right? Yep, Siemens load center. So we can do a 20 amp breaker, and we'll run a 20 amp right there for your refrigerator.
Okay.
And then that way your refrigerator will be on a separate, and the rain bird can be on the same circuit.
Okay.
Satisfied you were.
Oh, this is the review process here.
Yeah.
Well, John came to my house and did a great job. Everything's peachy keen and looks great, and so far so good. And when he leaves, it's probably gonna pop again. But
asshole.
That'll be the outtake.
Satisfied, you do it, customer.
Oh yeah, very satisfied.
There you go. You heard it.